There's a water tower in Eagan that hasn't held water in years, but what it does hold is valuable cell phone towers and a meaningful landmark for the people who live there. Well, now Eagan city leaders will decide what's next for the city's first water tower. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Naomi Peskovitz went to Eagan to explore the options.
That was then. This is now. More than 3 decades after this old photo, Eagan's oldest water tower still stands. Only the water inside the water tower is gone.
It doesn't help the system.
But it does connect the city in other ways, with several cell phone antennae which bring in about $150,000 a year. The tower is soon due for maintenance, like a good paint job. That would cost about $500,000.
That's when we started to think about it. Well, if we're not going to use this to store water, what type of repairs do we want to do?
It leaves the city with 3 basic options. Leave it up, take it down, or replace it with a new cell phone tower.
I think it should just stay, whether it's got water in it or not.
Cookie Litka, who's lived under the tower's watch for 15 years, says with or without a cell phone, it helps visitors find their way.
A lot of times, you know, when people call and say, well, where do you live? Because of the community. And I said, well, you know, I said, I just live right by the water tower. They said, oh, great. I know where that is.
Yeah, no one has any trouble finding Cookie's house at all.
Probably not. Yeah. And Ellen, you know what makes this so interesting is they don't have to decide this right now. They don't have to start work for another 3 to 5 years. So they are going to be asking from the city residents for input on their website and on the city's Facebook page in the next coming weeks, so residents can kind of weigh in.
Yeah, so I mean, this really is the beginning, and there are kind of some 3 major options that everyone is looking at. Is that right?
Right. They can leave it up, take it down, or put up a new cell phone tower in its place. But there have been some other options out there too, like a hydro battery to create energy for the city, even turn it into a piece of art. So really a ton of options out there. They really could do anything with it, but they do want to keep it as either a landmark or something to create some more money for the city.
Yeah, I mean, they're making $150,000 with this cell phone contract, right? So I'm sure that that is something that they don't want to lose.
Right, and there are other cities that do this, that get money out of these cell phone contracts. In fact, we looked into some other cities out there and what they do for these projects. In fact, in 2012, Savage got more than $200,000 in water tower lease payments. Woodbury generated more than $500,000 from cell contracts. And Brooklyn Park got more than $350,000 from cell towers. So a lot of cities use these kinds of projects. They're beneficial to not only the cities, but their residents and also other folks who drive through and need a little power for their cell phones as well.
Now, for people like Cookie and some of the other folks that maybe live in Eagan, is the Facebook page probably the best way to go to voice their opinion?
It will be. The city hasn't set that up quite yet, but they will be looking to that to set those up in a couple of weeks. And you can look to both their Facebook page and their website as well.
All right. Thanks, Naomi, for that. Eric.
Topping your headlines now around the world.